Can life be found on other planets? Is life only existent on planet Earth? If suddenly the Earth is destroyed, will we be able to survive in other planets? These are all profound questions we have asked ourselves from time to time. And the answer to this question is astrobiology. Astrobiology is the study of life in the universe in order to give us an insight into the origin, early evolution, and future of the universe. We are able to get answers through help from fields of study like astronomy, astroecology, biology, and many more. When we think of life in the universe, we think of two major factors, biotic and abiotic factors. Biotic factors are the living components of the universe, from plants, which are the producers, animals, which are the consumers like us, and saprophytes, which are the decomposers. As a result of living organisms being present in an ecosystem, factors like predation and competition arise. We cannot have an ecosystem without non-living organisms, and this is where abiotic factors come in place. Abiotic factors are basically the environmental factors of the universe, from soil topography to rainfall and climate change. As scientists consider that life, the search for life in the universe, we find out that there are challenges that organisms might face when sent out into the universe. We are able to survive these challenges due to development of structure, function, and behavior, which is known as astroadaptation. We are also able to interact with ourselves and our non-living environments, which is known as astroecology. Let's take one of these organisms for an instance, tardigrades. Tardigrades are segmented microorganisms which have been sent into the moon. They are organisms that are able to survive in environments with water surges through a process known as cryptobiosis. Also, NASA scientists have been able to show us that algae, bacteria, and asparagus are able to thrive and survive on Martian asteroids and meteorites. As we continue our search for life in the universe, we find out that there are thousands of exoplanets. Each of them have something distinct to them. Those in our particular interest are those in the Goldilocks zone. Planets in the Goldilocks zone are believed to have the right temperature for liquid water to be able to be present on the surface of those planets. Liquid water is one of the major components needed for survival of organisms in an ecosystem. The search for life in the universe is not an easy one, it's actually a short one. But who knows, in a matter of years, we might actually find life in the universe. Possibly, life will become sweeter to us through the help of astrobiology, as it reveals to us how biotic and abiotic factors will form an ecosystem and interact with themselves outside the universe.